Good afternoon. My name is Austin Wade. I'm from the Philippines. Right one. Let me tell you one thing about the Philippines. In the Philippines, there are many Filipinos, of course. There are about 70 million people in the Philippines. Many of them are Spanish Filipinos, Chinese Filipinos, and Filipinos Filipinos. We are almost in the Philippines, about 85% are Catholic. Religion is very important. People pray a lot. Sometimes, if you are in a Catholic school, you have to pray every class before the start of the class. English is a national language, but Tagalog is the language that is spoken in big cities and in some parts of the Philippines. But in some islands, there are 7,100 islands in the Philippines. Each island has its own dialect. So there are about 100 different dialects in the Philippines. Historically, everyone knows that the Philippines was under Spaniards for almost 500 years. So a lot of Filipinos have Spanish names, and a lot of rich Filipinos speak Spanish. Very educated Filipinos speak Spanish. And after Spaniards, we were under Americans. America was like our mother country. We were speaking English, taught in English, and everything was in English until the World War II, where Japan fought against America and they lost. And after that, we were under America again, and one time under England for a very, very short time. But now we are enjoying our independence since 1945. And by the way, I am from Calamba, Laguna. Calamba, Laguna is the birthplace of our national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal. Probably, he was a distant relative. He died for the country. So everybody knows him. Everybody knows my hometown, Calamba. After the Spaniards, after the Americans, after our independence, we had our first president, Manuel L. Quezon. And after that, Ramon Magsaysay, and after that, Macapagal, and then Marcos. Does everybody know Marcos? Marcos was the president of the Philippines who declared martial law, and he was the president by force almost for more than 20 years. And he took away all the wealth of the country, and he was outthrown to Hawaii by Cory Aquino, whose husband died and allegedly was killed by Marcos. Oh, the country is full of corruption. A lot of money was supposed to be given to the people, but the politicians were just like taking it to their own bank accounts in Switzerland. It's very complicated, but I don't have any right to say that as a Filipino because I have no proof. But if you read a little bit more about the country, it is full of corruption. This year, there's gonna be another election, and luckily, I think the most popular candidate is once a movie actor, Fernando Poe Jr., and everybody seems to be electing him even if he doesn't know anything about politics. It's because he was once a movie star. It's very complicated, but because of money, a lot of people can buy their way up to wherever they want to go. in the Philippines, money talks. And I can talk to you about a lot of other things, but maybe I have to go to your school and visit you one day. We can talk about that. Okay? Bye. See you. Oh, by the way, I forgot to tell you that if you have time, and of course you have to have a time at some time, look at Mr. Walsh's website. I wrote something about the Philippines and about a little bit about my hometown. Please don't forget to have some time to look at it. www. Oh, I think you have to ask Mr. Walsh. Bye.